Hey, what is up, you guys? Again, on Team Man Games, we're going to be doing something a little bit different. Today, we're going to be doing a review of a mouse. We're going to be looking at the Corsair Gaming Saber Optical RGB mouse, which I purchased fairly recently when I purchased my laptop a little while back. But, yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. So, let's get right into it. So, first of all, before we look at the mouse itself, we're going to be looking at the box. So, we can just push this aside, and we're going to take a look at the box. You can see that's a picture of the mouse on the cover. It is up to 6400 DPI. That's what its sensor goes up to. And if you're wondering what that is, that's actually kind of a simple way to put it. It's the sensitivity and how fast the mouse moves on the screen, or how sensitive it is. It actually has, I'll get into this more in a little, but it actually has a way to change that on the fly. Three zone, 16.8 million color backlighting. So that means that if you get the Corsair Utility Engine application for your computer, you can change that as much as you want to any variation of custom colors. I've yet to figure out how to pull up the menu that allows you to put in like custom colors, but you can see it also says that it's got 8 programmable easy access buttons, and then it just says down there Saber Optical RGB. And then also, if you open this up here, you can see that the mouse would normally be in there, but obviously I've had some time with it, so it's not in there, and I didn't feel like putting it back in. So enjoy virtually infinite customization, that's what it says, for the 16.8 million. And you can see right there that zone 1, that's the mouse wheel and the little area under it. Zone 2 is actually the underglow. It's kind of pointing to the light on the side there, but that's not actually how it works. And then the back one is obviously a little Corsair Gaming logo on the back with Corsair Gaming written under it. And then, on the back side of the box, if I can lift this over, you can see it just says some stuff, which I'm not going to read all of it through. So that is pretty much it. Let's just put the box out of the way. And now we're bringing in the actual mouse itself. Now, this actually is a really nice mouse. I really do enjoy it. And, definitely one of the nicest mice I've ever had. You can see on the bottom there's some dust. I don't know why that is. But you can see on the bottom, that's the, 6400 DPI, optical sensor down there. So, really nice, though. It tracks really well. I have this paired with a MM200 mouse pad from Corsair, which if you'd like to see a video on, be sure to leave a like on this one and a comment letting me know you would like to see that. But, let's start off here, I guess, with the cable. Very nice braided USB cable. I really like to see this, when it's braided. It makes it so much nicer and so much harder to actually get tangled. Also, this looks very nice, I must say, from a design standpoint. Because I know that's not something that really matters, but it's just that little bit of extra nice-lookingness, is a very nice addition. So you can see right here, it's got the scroll wheel, back, and forward arrows. This is a programmable key, which I have yet to assign to anything. You can hear it right there. I have no idea for what I should have assigned to that. And up here is what I was telling you about before, how you can change the DPI on the fly. So if you want your DPI to go up, like you're just, you're quickscoping or something, I really don't know. Then you can just press the up arrow up there, and it would change colors depending upon what you're adding. You can actually change what each section is. And then this one here is to go down in DPI, say, if you are sniping or something like that. And, this is just to look at it from the front. Sorry about that. And then there's a look at it from the back. You can see that it's got the little Corsair Gaming logo right there. So, definitely leave a like on the video if you guys do want to see more of these review-type videos. And if you would like to see a review of the MM200 mouse mat. Also, I will be doing a video, fairly soon, probably, maybe even the day you guys are seeing this video, a new graphics card which I'm getting, but I'm not going to tell you, exactly more on that until the video actually comes up. But that is pretty much it, you guys. Definitely be sure to leave a like if you guys do want to see more review type things. I actually really do like doing these. But that is pretty much it. Thank you for watching. And if you do, please like, subscribe, more than all, and I hope to see you next time.